In terms of the deployment of this capital, Alex, around this really fascinating company, does it go on the compute? You build out your own models. We know how intensive that is in terms of cost, the build out of compute, the needs for those chips, the infrastructure. How much of the funding goes towards the infrastructure? How much towards the build out of the business, the hiring of talent?
This round is super exciting for us as a team because it gives us the capital to go and invest further in these spaces. It's really all about taking the technology we've been building for 7 years now and being able to turn it into a product for the automotive industry. So we're going to be investing further in increasing the data and compute to be able to train this AI. The scale of ambition we have here, I think, goes beyond what we've seen from large language models today. Being able to train an AI that we can trust to physically interact with us in the world, and of course, turning it into a product, building the robust safety architectures to make this a winning and trusted solution in the automotive market.
And trust is really important. And there's a differentiation between what you guys do and some of the other competitors out there, because your model is based, your system is based on this AI model. So it takes in the inputs from its outside environment, feeds it back into the model, the inputs as well from the driver, those who are behind the wheel. Very different from some of the other prospects out there. How wide is the moat now that you have versus your competitors?
Well, it's been a different approach for the last 7 years, one that's been contrarian to the rest of the industry.
Yeah.
The AV 1.0, the first generation of these technologies, built systems that would largely follow or work within constrained areas following a high-definition map that told them how to operate. What we've built is an embodied AI system, and I really want to extend the conversation in AI from chatbots and co-pilots and search engines to things like AlphaFold that we just heard about. Or embodied AI, bringing AI into the physical world. That's really the big opportunity that we have here. We've been pioneering this technology here out of London and now with our team around the world to come up with some of the ideas that can allow it to be robust and trusted in the physical world and ultimately now start operating in the automotive industry.
And so, you were contrarian, and famously Musk as well, and he changed his view. You had a conversation with him at one point and he challenged you on your view on this. People are coming around to this system that you're putting in place, including, it seems, Elon Musk as well. So in terms of that moat that you have, are you feeling that competitive pressure now, Alex?
Well, ultimately, we want to be deploying the... Pressure is a privilege. We're excited to be building it out here. But ultimately, we want to build an AI that can be a platform across the whole automotive industry. And I guess what I'd say is I think the safest and most performant system is going to be trained with the data and experience from the largest diversity of experience from all of the automotive brands, and we really want to see experience across the industry and provide that solution to
you've been
brands
testing,
themselves.
You've been testing the system here in the UK since 2018. Give us the time frame. When do we expect to see these cars deployed on the roads?
It's coming. We're not going to give a specific time frame because we don't want to add to the hype of the industry. I really want to make sure we can be heads down and focused and build this. But, just yesterday, I was on a demo drive through central London. We can, our system can drive with hands off, where you have no interaction with the controls of the car, drive through all of the complexities of central London around Trafalgar Square, Big Ben, all of these kind of sites. And of course, you know the complexity we have on the road here with cyclists, buses cutting in and out, taxis. That's the kind of environment it operates in.
There's a brand image problem, isn't there, around autonomous driving? And you're at the kind of centre of trying to change that. Is that fair to say? There have been a number of accidents from some of your competitors using different systems. How much of a challenge is that? You're having to change the branding around autonomous driving. The promises have been significant. We haven't matched them, but you're part of trying to reset that?
I think the benefits are enormous, and I think the world is aligned around those. Of course, improving road safety, freeing up time, improving the sustainability of transportation. So we're all aligned on that.
How do you convince people that these are safe systems?
It's by setting the right expectations, and I think the model we're taking about getting the system deployed as driver assistance first, so being able to improve the active safety of your driving, being able to reduce the stress and while you still monitor the system, is the right way to get started to earn trust. And then, of course, the experience of deploying in millions of vehicles will allow us to grow the system quickly from driver assistance to full autonomy. Mm-hmm. I think that's a better model than starting immediately with robo-taxis in an unproven way. So we want to grow the technology, earn trust, and work with regulators.
Alex, how much runway does this funding give you? An IPO has to be in the back of your mind. I know you're going to say we're heads down, we're working on the product right now, we're not focused on the IPO, but it's there, Alex. I know it's there. Give us some sense as to the listing plans for this business and whether it could ever happen in the UK.
Well, this funding gives us, it funds our entire business plan, which is, I mean, it's a real delight as an entrepreneur to have that, and it lets us go and build out this technology.
Are we talking 12 months?
We need to get the product shipped first, and so that's what we're focused on right now. Yeah. So you're right, we are heads down. When we earn the right to have a conversation around an IPO, we'll have it.
When that conversation comes, it's not going to be the UK, is it, frankly?
I'm not going to wade into that conversation right now.
Okay.
We're pretty focused on what we're doing.
In terms of the data, who owns it? Is it the driver? Is it your customers? Is it you?
We have commercial arrangements to use a wide variety of data. One of the interesting things is we can train our system, of course, on the driving experience from the autonomous vehicles we work with or the automotive manufacturers we partner with. Also, internet scale data, dash cam data. This is the amazing thing about AI right now is that it's becoming multimodal and able to bring together sources of data across the board to ensure we can build the most intelligent system with the general purpose reasoning to deal with the long tail of edge cases you
what
see on the road.
Potential top line market value of this particular sector, Alex?
I mean, you can read some management consulting quotes that it's in the trillions, and I really believe that. I think
you think this is a potentially trillion-dollar market.
Embodied AI is the next wave of tooling. You know, we've had calculators, computers, actually having machines that are intelligent, that you can trust, that you can delegate tasks to, and can help support your life. I mean, this is just bringing enormous potential. Autonomous driving will be the first example of this, because there exists the data, the vehicles, the business model to get going. But we're going to see a whole wealth of different intelligent machines that will really support our lives, and embodied AI is what makes this possible.
Okay.